double trouble.
Commitment.
Everlasting.
Really a genuinely nice guy and he's very caring.
I guess his charisma.
His smile.
Personality. Good looks.
I would say simplicity.
It's what I expected, but it's a steep learning curve at the same time.
It's has its ups and downs, but it's, you know, at the end of the day, it's really, it's, you know, I don't want to change anything.
To be
totally not.
No. No. And then having children is a completely different level.
You kind of make expectations about what you think marriage is going to be like, but it's, you know, times that by 1,000.
Mm. It's everything and a lot more. She loves her slippers to be together all the time. Even if they're away by like 1 centimeter, she has to go and, you know, put them together.
He's snoring.
But he sleeps a lot.
She talks too much.
His nose hair.
Lack of mathematical
such an untidy Peter, like, leaves everything everywhere, and worst offense of all, he takes toothpaste in the middle of the bed tube. He washes the dishes without me asking.
He buys me a lot of presents, like, spontaneously.
He tries to do whatever makes me happy.
He's there for me no matter what happens. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
She thinks about me in every little thing.
Just in the way he accepts me.
Talking to me, sitting and chatting about things that are important to me. And
obsessed with housework and what I call him being totally untidy, so I don't think we're ever going to see eye to eye on that.
Who's tired more?
One of the big things we argue about is division of duties.
Sometimes you just argue about the most things that seem really big when you're arguing about.
Yeah, I think so.
I don't think so.
No.
Absolutely.
Yes, sort of. We've got kids, so we try.
You can't even fathom how selfish she used to be.
Definitely it's changed. It was all about me before.
It's about him first. I think it's made me a little bit less selfish.
Changing my thinking from me to us, basically.
Opening up your mind and also learning more about yourself.
Ensure that this happiness that we found together lasts for a really long time.
How we approach our marriage and how we can get along better and argue less.
To gain a better understanding of our relationship and of ourselves and how we can make our relationship better.
Probably try and maximise the positives and minimise the negatives. Mm.
Even though every marriage has its ups and downs, I just want to learn how to manage those better.
We'd like to hear what Swamiji's thoughts are, and there's always room to make a better marriage.
I think our marriage is good, there's nothing to complain about, but there's always room for improvement, and someone like Swamiji can really get to the bottom of that.
The prince met the princess and asked her, "Will you marry me?" And guess what? The princess said no, and they lived happily ever after. For most people, that's living happily ever after. However, marriage is a wonderful institution to gain happiness, and there's a spiritual side to marriage which very few people know, which enriches marriage, makes marriage more beautiful, meaningful, and fulfilling.